Hello kids, today we are going to revise the lesson Globe. Globe is a model of our earth. What is globe? Globe as a model of the earth. We know that one. The globe means a model of our earth. Important lines on the globe and its structure we already learned. In the previous class, we learned today we are going to only revise because all of you are promoted to next class. You all are promoted to 6th standard. But we want to revise previous class some topics. Yes or no, kids? So that we are going to revise the lesson, The Globe. Our planet Earth, like all other planets, is spherical in shape. It appears blue in color when seen from the space. However, had there not been a small model of this huge planet, it would be impossible for man to locate far off places on it. Two important tools used to study the Earth. One is the globe and one is the map. Globe is a model of the Earth which shows us it's a different features on a smaller scale. The picture alongside shows you what the earth looks like. A globe shows the exact location, shape, and gives an idea about the relative size of all the land areas as well as the water bodies on the earth. A globe shows the exact location, shape, and give an idea about the relative size of all the land areas as well as the water bodies on the earth. Do you know, kids? The word globe comes from the Latin word globus. The globe word came from Latin word globus, mean round mass. Globe means in Latin word globus. Globus means round mass or sphere. People who make map are called a cartographer. People who make maps are called cartographers. See kids, water bodies, continents, poles, hemispheres, we learn this one all now on this one globe. Water bodies. The large water bodies are called oceans, are seen in blue color. There are 5 oceans on the earth. How many oceans are there? 5. How many oceans are there? 5. One is Atlantic Ocean. Second one is Pacific Ocean. Third is the Indian Ocean. Fourth one is Southern Ocean. And fifth one is Arctic Ocean. Total 5 oceans are there. Where? On the earth. There are 5 oceans are there on the earth. Tell me, which one 5 oceans are there? The Atlantic Ocean, the Pacific Ocean, 1 Atlantic Ocean, 2 Pacific Ocean, 3 the Indian Ocean, 4 Southern Ocean, 5 the Arctic Ocean. Understood, no kids? Total 5 oceans, big oceans are there on the earth. Now, continents, large extensive masses of land on the earth are called the continents. Large extensive masses of land on the earth are called continents. Asia, Africa, North America, South America, Europe, Australia and Antarctica. How many over? Seven. Seven continents are there. And five oceans are there. First one, Asia. Second, Africa. Third, North America. Four, South America. Five, Europe. Six, Australia. Seventh, Antarctica. Are the seven continents on this earth. Understood, no kids? Five oceans and seven continents are there in this one earth. Poles. The earth constantly rotates. This earth constantly rotates or turns on its axis of rotation. This axis is an imaginary line passing through the earth that points north point and the south points. North pole, south pole. Look at this one picture. The earth has two poles. Northernmost point is the north pole and southernmost point is the south pole. This is the north pole, this one, and this is the south pole. This part is called the north hemisphere and down part is the southern hemisphere and middle line is the equator. From here to here, north pole, this all part, sorry, north hemisphere. This is the north pole, this is the north pole and this pole is the south pole. From here, to above, this is the north hemisphere. From here to here, this one all north hemisphere. And from here to the downside, this one is the southern hemisphere. And the line is there, no, which divide the north pole and south pole. This line is called the equator. It's called the equator. Now see, hemisphere. Northern north hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Northern hemisphere, southern hemisphere, two space are there. The imaginary line which divides the earth into two equal halves, that is called the equator. The imaginary line which divides the earth into two equal halves, that is called the equator. Area lying below the equator, sorry, above the equator, this is called the northern hemisphere, and the area below the hemisphere, equator, which lies below the equator, this is called the southern hemisphere. Do you know, kids? Many globes show other types of water bodies such as gulfs, bays, major five rivers, and lakes. Some globes show again some water bodies, such as a gulfs, bays, major rivers and lakes. In this, we are seeing only oceans. Important lines on the globe and its structure. Important lines and the important lines on the globe and its structure. You know, kids, it is easier to locate places on the globe because of the horizontal and vertical lines drawn on it. Horizontal lines and vertical lines drawn on it. Parallel of latitude. Parallels of latitude. When we look at the globe, We find horizontal lines drawn on it, running parallel to equator. See, it is the equator, and the lines running parallel to the equator. These are called the latitudes or parallels of latitude. The line running horizontal, the lines running parallel to the equator. These horizontal lines are called latitudes or parallel latitudes. Look here, these are the latitudes. On this picture, see, kids. The vertical lines on the globe, these are the vertical lines on the globe which run from North Pole to South Pole are called the longitudes. Latitudes are running parallel to the equator, and the lines from North Pole to South Pole, the lines, vertical lines on the globe which run from North Pole to South Pole are called the longitudes or meridians. The prime meridian, the 0 degree longitudes, divides the earth into two equal vertical hemispheres, the east hemisphere and the west hemisphere. Understood, no kids? Okay. See. Now, what we are revised? We revised about globe. What is globe? Globe is a small model of the earth which shows us its different features on a smaller scale. 2. The large water bodies are called the oceans. What are oceans? Large water bodies are called oceans. Large extensive masses of land are called the continents. Large extensive masses of land are called the continents. How many oceans are there, kids? 5 oceans. And how many continents are there? 7 continents. Okay? The imaginary line that divides the earth into two, northern and southern hemisphere, that is called the equator. The imaginary line that run parallel to the equator, they are called latitudes or parallel of latitudes. And the line, imaginary vertical lines that run from North Pole to South Pole, north to south, and meet at the poles are called the longitudes or meridians. The 0 degree longitude is called the prime meridian. How much degree longitude is called the prime meridian? 0 degree. 0 degree longitude is called as prime meridian and pass through the Greenwich, England. 0 degree longitude is called the prime meridian and it passes through the Greenwich, England. Longitudes and latitudes greatly help in locating the places on the earth. Longitudes and latitudes greatly help in locating places on the earth. Understood, my kids? What we are revised? These all points we are learned in the previous class, means in the 5th standard. Now again once time we are revised, because this time you are promoted to 6th standards, means you are grown up, no? So how you are feeling? You are promoted to means you are feeling good, no? Okay, but you see the video carefully, read the lesson and remove the small points. Means what is latitude, what is longitude, what is globe, what are water bodies, Okay, what are continents, how many continents are there, how many water bodies are there. You read the lesson, you will get the answers. Understood, no? Okay, today's homework is what? Today's homework is you read the lesson carefully, because we already solved the question answers, fill in the blanks, all exercise part we solved it. In revision part, we are going to just read. And if you want, you draw one small globe picture on the plain paper. You draw the globe, this type of globe picture, and label this one part. Okay? On one page, take one big page and draw this one and color it. Understood, no kids? Thank you.